Today, I want to talk about the peaceful phlegmatic. These are your cool, calm, and collected individuals. They are even-tempered, they show little emotion, they look very balanced, they are not demanding. Whatever you say, babe, that's okay with me. They seem to be kind-hearted, and they try to make people feel comfortable around them, and they can be a very refreshing for other temperaments because of their calming nature. Now, the weaknesses of this temperament type is that they can be uninvolved. Other people can experience them to be unemotional. They have no depth. They are not interested. They may look like they are lazy. They don't want to work hard. And in relationships with the opposite sex, they may have a difficult time having deep relationships because they don't like anything that is going to cause any kind of conflict. So they avoid conflict at all costs, and you might find them to not really be good at self-sacrificing, you know, going overboard to help another person. They are not going to do that. And on the extreme, you might find them to be stubborn and consistent in that stubbornness, even though we do know that if they are kind-hearted, they are consistently kind-hearted. Then the other thing about them is that they procrastinate. So they may have a difficult time implementing and following through the things that they are supposed to do. So when you are a phlegmatic, one of the things that you would need to work on is the fact that people may experience you as uninterested. So if you are in a relationship, what you want to do is to make sure that you up your ability to show interest in the other person. When you are a phlegmatic, tends to feel like, I don't want to be bothered. You know, I'm going to do it at my own time. And especially men who are phlegmatic, their wives tend to experience them as not interested in the family, not putting as much effort in the family as they should. And so it would be very important to kind of look at yourself and see, is this an area that I need to work on? Because it's not that you are not interested. That's the way people experience you because of the way you deal with life. The other thing that you would need to work on as a phlegmatic is procrastination. And this one will get you into a lot of trouble, whether it is at work, whether it is in your personal life, or whether it is in your whenever you are trying to do investments or you have dreams and goals you want to achieve, because of not wanting. I usually look at the phlegmatic as not wanting to assert themselves. They just want to go with what is easy. You are too comfortable. And so you want to challenge yourself and be able to say, if I have these goals that I have for my life, then I need to put the effort to make those goals come to pass. It's not that you can't, you will. And so you would have to look at what is the hindrances, what are the self-sabotaging motivations here, what is my subconscious telling me that is causing me not to reach the goals that we have. Now, phlegmatics might be those people who are in school forever. They never finish the degree. They are still, you know, they go and then they give up, or they didn't attend the classes they were supposed to, so they get referred. They are the people who are loyal in a job, but they never get a promotion because they are not asserting themselves. They are not pushing themselves to be the best that they can be. And so the skills that the phlegmatic would need to really work on is that skill of really seeing themselves as successful. Create that picture in your mind and then work towards it. Do what it takes for you to reach that. Because just the fact that you're not doing it doesn't mean you're not interested in doing it. It just means that you would have to make more effort. These things are not going to happen by themselves. And so the phlegmatic will need to borrow a leaf from the choleric, who is very goal-oriented. And the phlegmatic, we know they will make plans, but they will not implement them. So what do you need? You will need a coach. You will need a mentor. You will need somebody who holds you accountable. And if you do that, once you get into the routine of doing these things, then you can pick it up by yourself. But most phlegmatics, they will, if they are willing, they will need somebody to hold their hands and encourage them to reach those goals that they have set for their lives. So the relationship part of the phlegmatic can be very challenging, because most phlegmatics are attracted to the opposite. They will go with the person who looks like they are more focused on life. They are goal oriented, and so when you are a phlegmatic and you marry or you get involved with a person who is on the opposite end, you will eventually resent them, because they will be trying to push you, but you're feeling like they are coming into your personal space. So you would need to really know that about your relationship and begin to make the adjustments that you need to. So until I see you next time, continue to live by design and reach out to us. We would be glad to walk with you through this journey of self-awareness, knowing your temperament and finding the areas of growth so that you can become the best you that you need to become.